a Porsche with a hybrid system. At a Porsche with four seats, the Panamera has already dished out its share of surprises for sports car fans. Now for the second generation, the Panamera 4 plug-in e-hybrid has been joined by another with 500 kilowatts of system power. But for today, we'll stick with the less powerful plug-in hybrid. Its electric motor and 243 kilowatt V6 gasoline engine add up to a total system power of 340 kilowatts. Fuel consumption is rated at just 2.5 liters per 100 kilometers, but only as long as the driver resists the temptation to really step on it. Our tester Reinhold Deisenhofer points out that since the Panamera e-hybrid weighs 2.2 tons, it takes some power to push that weight from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in just 5 seconds. But the system has a good 700 newton meters of torque. The normal drive mode recharges the battery on the go. And then there are the Sport and Sport Plus modes. In all three, the overboost function temporarily steps up the boost pressure for the pickup typical of Porsche.
Übersteuert immer alles, und das ist typisch Porsche.
As in most hybrids, the display can show the energy flow at any time. A Porsche is a Porsche is a Porsche. The design has spoken the same easily recognizable language for decades, and the Panamera is no exception. The e-hybrid differs from the four-seater's gasoline-powered version only in small details, such as the green rim badging and the green brake calipers. The Panamera 4 e-hybrid is 5 meters and 5 centimeters long. The longer executive body style is available on request. Tucked under the front hood is the V6 with 2.9 liters capacity. Reinhold realizes that with a Porsche, sound is always a factor. In all-electric drive, the e-hybrid glides over the asphalt on its air suspension in almost total silence. But if you really bring out the performance, it sounds just like the Porsches we've always known. The Panamera e-hybrid pounces from 80 to 120 kilometers per hour in just 3.1 seconds, only a fraction of a second slower than other Panamera variants, because of the few hundred extra kilos the battery adds. Reinhold explains that it takes about 6 hours to fully recharge the e-hybrid's battery from a European 220-volt household outlet. A quick charge station for an extra 4,500 euros will cut 2 hours off that time. The Panamera e-hybrid's competitors are the Mercedes-Benz S500 and the BMW 7 Series in plug-in hybrids. But in the family of Panameras, the Porsche e-hybrid is actually the lowest priced of them all.